ministered this year, Brother Jimmy, and stood before people.
Yeah.
All the different times, all the different people that I've ministered to, and seen people healed and delivered and set free. I talked to a young man last night,
yeah.
and he had a disease, something that was incurable, Sister Murray. But to Jesus, come on the scene.
Amen.
And he's alive and well today.
Amen.
I mean, folks, can you imagine how low that we give?
Yeah.
And Almighty God, we call on Jesus. It says, wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name above every name.
Yes.
That name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Just say every knee.
Every
knee shall bow.
Every knee shall bow.
Of things in heaven, the things in the earth, things beneath the earth. And we've been given that mighty name. We see miracle after miracle. We see signs. We see wonders because we have faith in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm glad I'm saved and I'm a believer.
Amen.
You know, there's some folks saved and they don't believe nothing.
Yeah, that's true.
But I believe today in the Lord Jesus Christ. His power to save. His power to keep. He's got a keeping power. And we've seen a lot fall by the way. But folks, they had a choice. They had an opportunity.
Come on. Yeah.
It says, tarry until you are endued with power from on high. And folks, I mean, can you imagine it? And what it's saying to tarry around the altar, to stay and tarry until you receive the Holy Ghost power, until you receive the boldness. And folks, I teach a baptismal measure. And the book of Acts, it says that the Holy Ghost came and sat upon all them, and they spake in the heavenly language as the Spirit gave them the utterance. And they were filled up, and they were overflowing.
Amen.
And they had a saucer around it, and got blessed to it. Do you hear what I'm saying? But there's a baptismal measure that Christ says to tarry until you're endued with power from on high.
Yeah.
In Acts 1, they say you'll receive power after the Holy Ghost has come. In Acts chapter 2, said this is that which is spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last day, said God, I'll pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Sons and daughters shall prophesy, young men see vision, old men dream dreams, and on my servants and handmaids in those days, while I pour out of my spirit.
Amen.
And they'll prophesy. I'll show wonders in the heavens above. And signs in the earth we need. Folks, we need the baptism of the Holy Ghost in this last day. We just need more of God. That's a definition of baptism is more of God. It's the fullness of God. It's the baptismal measure. It's like being submerged into the Spirit of God, into the face of God.
Amen.
Folks, He gives you a desire to seek hard after God. Paul said, I pray for the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. And we're to tarry until we receive that power. We took in at home church years back, a little lady prayed, I think, 3 years for the baptism. And said she just tarried and she waited and sought God and finally got baptized. And the Lord baptized me in 3 weeks. You know, I got saved. And about 3 weeks later, He baptized in the Holy Ghost. But folks, it's wonderful. The next best thing to salvation is the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
It said, the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body. The Spirit, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, are sons of God. That little word quicken, and you see us jump up and down.
Quick.
You see us squirm, and you see us holler and hoot. And boy, we just enjoy the God.
Yes.
We enjoy the blessing. You know, sometimes I'll be walking in the yard, and I'll go, woo! And it just feels good. I don't have to have the great plan of God or not. I just kind of feel good.
Hallelujah. You know, to me, I may correct people, but it's because I love them.
accept it because I love them. And if I correct them and I criticize them, they might not accept it, Pastor Dallas. But you know, when we have a love of God, just like God's love, he corrects us and he chastens us, but it's because he loves. There's no greater love that a man will lay down his life for his friends. He says, he prepares a table for me in the presence of mine enemies. You know, to David and Saul, and David really wasn't the enemy to Saul, but Saul seen this one. So David, you're wanting my kingdom. You're wanting to be king over me. But you know, the blessings of God just kept on pouring out upon David.
Yes.
Wisdom, knowledge, understanding. I mean, can you imagine, right? It says he prepares a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. I mean, folks, can you imagine the presence of God? Even though they were enemies, then God just kept blessing David.
Amen.
And folks, sometimes we get around people that might not like us, but you know, that's all